If you're self-seeking and honest then, and stop deceiving lonely.
Sam Smith, Like I Can. So we need your help with something for Eurovision. Yes, very, very exciting indeed. And more of the best things you've seen over this bank holiday weekend. And we do appreciate not everybody is on a bank holiday today. It's Nikki and Bazzoe, and this is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app on your smart speaker and on 88.91 FM.
BBC News at 8 o'clock on Easter Monday, the 10th of April. Good morning, this is Adam Porter. The Labour leader says he stands by a controversial election ad that's caused deep unease within his own party. Health officials in England are making final preparations for what they're calling the most disruptive strike in the history of the NHS. And the UK has nominated seven areas to be considered as World Heritage Sites. Sir Keir Starmer has defended an online advert released by Labour last week, accusing Rishi Sunak of not wanting child sex abusers to be jailed. Writing in the Daily Mail, Sir Keir said he made absolutely zero apologies for the campaign because the Prime Minister and successive Conservative governments had put the criminal justice system on a path of decline. But some senior figures in the Labour Party have called for the ad to be withdrawn. The Tory MP Conor Burns is one of those who says it was a mistake to post it.
This was a grubby little advert, and I think it'll leave the public pretty cold. I think we should absolutely have a debate about crime. It's something that concerns the communities that we all serve. But I think we do politics and public discourse a disservice if we get into the gutter of trading these sort of insults at one another.
NHS England has said that emergency and urgent care will be prioritised when junior doctors go on strike tomorrow. It's warning that the four-day walkout will be the most disruptive in the history of the health service. Richard Galpin has more details.
The National Medical Director of NHS England, Professor Sir Stephen Powis, is warning that the 4 days of walkouts by junior doctors in what is a bitter dispute over pay will bring immense pressures on staff and services. But it's expected that while some routine appointments will be delayed as people with life-threatening conditions are given priority, operations will only be cancelled when it's unavoidable. And for those waiting for alternative dates for appointments, he says these will be provided as soon as possible.
Defence officials in the United States and around the world are assessing the damage caused by the release of dozens of highly classified documents. The leaks, first reported on Friday, contain details of Ukraine's planned spring offensive, as well as intelligence about China, the Middle East and Africa. Investigators in Washington have told the Reuters news agency that they're looking into whether a disgruntled government employee or a spy might have been responsible. The former chief of staff to the head of the CIA, Larry Pfeiffer, says it's probably the most serious leak of classified information in the US in the past 5 years.
It could potentially put sensitive sources and methods at risk, be they human beings who may have been the source of material or some sensitive collection platform, the disclosure of which now may result in mitigation efforts to prevent the collection of those audio signals in the future. It's sowed distrust amongst allies, particularly allies working against Russia in Ukraine.
The Prime Minister has said it's time for power sharing between political parties to return to Northern Ireland on the 25th anniversary of the Good Friday Agreement. Rishi Sunak will join the US President Joe Biden on a visit there tomorrow to commemorate the deal that brought an end to years of violence in the region. Mr. Sunak says he stands ready to work with parties to get the Stormont Assembly up and running again. Buckingham Palace has given details of the processional routes which will be used by King Charles and the Queen Consort on Coronation Day. Our royal correspondent Nicholas Witchell reports.
It will be on a more modest scale than the coronation of the late Queen Elizabeth, with far fewer guests in Westminster Abbey, and a procession back to Buckingham Palace which will only cover about a quarter of the distance compared to 1953. But many of the traditional elements will be the same. The crown jewels, the regalia, symbols of the monarch's authority, the sovereign's orb and sceptres, the swords, bracelets and spurs, all will have a part in this elaborate religious service before Charles is crowned with St. Edward's crown.
The government has put forward seven sites to be considered for UNESCO World Heritage status. Birkenhead Park on Merseyside and York City Centre are among the locations in the running to join the list, which includes the Pyramids of Egypt and Stonehenge. Alison Norman organises tours of York and says the city deserves to be recognised.
There are very few cities that have the heritage that we have managed to keep in York. You know, from the times in the 1830s when the city council wanted to knock our wonderful medieval walls down, we have had people and individuals in the city who have done much to protect the buildings, the road structure from the incursion of modernity.
And the weather forecast, a mixture of sunshine and blustery showers for much of the UK, a chance of thunder in the east of England. Top temperatures of 11 Celsius in Belfast, 12 in Edinburgh, 13 in Cardiff and 14 in London. BBC News, it's 8:05.
Thank you very much, Adam.
Listen live on the BBC Sounds app. The Radio 2 Breakfast Show. With Nikki Chapman.
Yes, good morning and welcome.